So, Rhonda, tell us about what kind of activities that they love to do and what you guys do here. Because as we're talking about social engagement, we want to talk about what you're actually doing and what the residents love. So give us kind of a synopsis.
Okay, my friends. So, BeanBag Baseball. Our residents are competitive. They love the sport. So just a little bit of an explanation. It's similar to cornhole. So we've got our board at the, it's 15 feet out. They're throwing bean bags, actual baseballs that are made in a bean bag, throwing it down on the board. There's home runs, there's first, second, and third. There's outs also. They have their chairs. So once they get on base, be it second or third or home run, they're going to bring all their folks in that are sitting and waiting, and that last one got a home run and around they come. So they're being physically active, they're emotionally engaged,
they're part of a team.
Part of a team, and they're using the like counting, you know what I mean?
Because
you're kind of
exactly
how many different it's using all of it. Really.
It is very competitive. We we just recently competed against another community as
Oh, well. So yeah, absolutely.
And we are getting ready to hold a tournament. Several other communities are going to come here to Pinewood Hills.
So what's the name of your team?
Oh, gosh, we are the Pinewood Hills Panthers.
Don't even go there.
Okay. Well, and we're lucky enough today, they were setting up when we got here. So we're going
to
go take some pictures so
you
can actually see in action what we're talking about. If you can't quite visualize what it is, we will show you.
Yes. Today, they will not be in their uniform. But
they
we actually have uniforms? We actually have uniforms. We wear our black tops and we have this nice little scarf and they've got little ball caps.
We need a picture of that to share with everyone.
We will get you one.
That probably hits all the boxes, right? Like Lori said, teamwork. Engagement, physical, mental thinking, keeping your mind going,
social skills,
but the competitiveness.
And so that's a good one.
And plus you're laughing and having a great time. So.
Oh, and we even have some that prefer not to play, but they love being our cheerleaders.
I have a little row set up
and they're waving the pom-poms.
Well, there you go.
So covering everything. Very engaged. Love it.
Excellent. So we also talked about some of like your favorite things. So another favorite thing would be outings. So tell us a little bit about the outings.
Okay, so we have many outings. They love the thrill of getting out of the building. We'll go on an outing. It may be a museum. It may be a historical marker. It may be the Goatman Bridge.
We all know about that.
Yes. I've wanted to go there.
Yeah, I haven't done that. Google that.
Goatman Bridge in Denton, right?
Yes. Mm-hmm. So they're very engaged. They love getting out of the building. They love the social time that they have on the bus. They're going with the buddy system more or less because they sit two by two on the bus and away they go. So they get time to socialize, chit chat with their neighbors. And then when we get to our museum or going out to eat is huge.
Oh, I can imagine.
A lot of times we will go to a museum or we will go and see a historical marker and we'll learn the history on this and then we go have lunch afterwards. Just a few months ago, we did make a visit to Paula Dean's restaurant in McKinney, Fairview portion of McKinney, and guess who greeted us at the door? Paula Dean herself. She was so,
so
welcoming, that true Southern hospitality.
Oh. Did her hair look as good as it does on TV?
Oh, she looks beautiful. She's a beautiful woman.
Yeah,
but she's lost so much.
She has.
It's amazing, just amazing.
She cut out the butter.
Yeah, she cut out the butter, that's right. Hey, y'all. That's right.
So the biscuits are a little bit flatter, but they're so delicious.
That's right. And she was so into our arrival. She met us at the door. She welcomed the residents in.
Oh, that's so sweet of her.
She took individual photos. She took group photos.
Shout out to Paula Dean.
Exactly.
Hey, Paula Dean.
Lori and I are waiting for an invitation.
Yes.
That's right. So she was so welcoming to all of us. She sat and chit-chatted with all the residents, and she's like, I'm in your chapter of life, and yes, I love getting to know you guys. And she was so involved and just was so pleased that we had chosen to come to her restaurant, and the residents loved it.
Of
the
course.
Food was phenomenal.
I'm sure.
Food was phenomenal.
Sure
was. So away we came on our travels back to the community, and there was so much chatter on the bus you couldn't think. So we loved it.
And she has pictures of Paula Dean with the residents, and so we're going to share those too.
Yes.
I can't wait to see them.
We will get you
up
close and personal on that.
Yeah. So those outings, we have one outing that is to the casino every third Wednesday of the month. They absolutely love that.
Yeah.
And, you know, it's a lot of walking going to those casinos.
Mm-hmm.
So they're getting exercise, they're being challenged physically, mentally, and they're using those social skills. So
yes,
we love that.
Yep,
we love
wonderful.
That. That's
and
right.
Hopefully they win.
Yeah.
Some good, some happy, some sad.
Come with a little extra money.
Right. So we go to the casino once a month, and the fourth Wednesday of every month, we have a mystery trip.
I love this. This is great.
So they do not have any idea where we're going. We do not get off the bus at all.
Mm-hmm.
That away, those that struggle a little bit and they might have a challenge, be it handicap accessible or, you know, having to tow
too much walking.
Too much walking.
Yeah.
We want to accommodate them. And there's lots of folks that just enjoy going for a ride in the country.
Mm-hmm.
But I want to keep them engaged, and I want them to be using those brain cells. It's so important. Think. So I challenge them. I give them little hints. We'll have a whole spill, and they're guessing the whole way to that final stop. That final stop. So,
I remember those days. Yeah. We used to do that.
Yeah, so we're not just sitting around playing bingo, as a lot of folks think of retirement communities. Oh, they're just playing bingo.
No.
But we do play bingo. We play your regular bingo for money. We have chocolate bingo.
Oh,
and sometimes,
chocolate bingo.
Yeah, and sometimes we have bingo for whatever a sponsor brings. So we never know what that's going to be. There's The Price is Right. They absolutely adore The Price is Right. They're always saying, where are you going to buy from next, Rhonda?
Uh-huh.
And I'm like, I can't tell you until the day comes for the
price. Because I don't have a clue yet.
Well, there may be that too. Yes. So, right. On your mystery tour, tell us some of the places you've gone, like the biggest,
the
exciting
last,
places.
Yes, the last one, we had a full bus and a waiting list. Sadly, some of them did not get to go because if you don't sign up quickly, the bus fills up quickly and you'll have to make it the next go around. So, we went for a quick little ride up to Lake Ray Roberts. And we told them about some of the archaeological finds that were, or the pieces that was found when the lake was going in. And also a little insight, Tom, our bus driver, part of that land for Lake Ray Roberts was his grandfather's land. So he had like a personal touch, and he was able to share his own personal connection about that mystery trip. And they loved the dam.
Awesome.
The bus driver, Tom, has a way of talking with folks. So he spoke with one of the park rangers, and they let the bus in for no charge. And
good job,
they got
Tom.
To drive that shout out, right? So they got to drive through the park itself, saw the beach area, saw where the flooding had recently taken place, and all the new construction that's going on. So it was a little added benefit there. So
that's
awesome. They love getting out in the country, you know, seeing the water. No one had any idea about the dam. So they were told a little bit of history
about that.
So you think you're going to move to one of these communities and just sit around?
No, they're doing independent
living.
No, they're doing things that I didn't even know about or that I've always wanted to do and I've never done.
I know.
So. Yeah. As we
I
want to go on the trips.
You know, when you come into a retirement community, you can be as active or inactive as you want to be. But we want you to be active as long as you're exercising your brain cells, you're moving those joints, the bodies are in motion at all times. You can age in place per se, but not falter in place, if that makes sense.
That's really good. I like that. And we're all about that. As you know, on our show, we talk all about it, keeping active, keeping engaged. And Rhonda is leading that parade of keeping you engaged. So,
wonderful.
Come find her. Come find her. She's kicking it.
Come hang out with us.
Absolutely. Yeah. We're going on the bus next, though.